Well, joining us now, somebody who's tracked and met and interacted extensively with the departed leader, Ashok Mallick joins us now. Thanks very much for being with us. What do you believe was Jaswant Singh's most lasting contribution as a political leader? Would it be his breakthrough with the United States?
Well, he served India in many positions, as you said, as an army officer who was part of the mobilization in 62. Though I don't think he was actually part of the fighting. And of course, as a political figure, like President Pranab Mukherjee, he held three important portfolios: defense, foreign affairs, or external affairs, finance, and was deputy chairman of the Planning Commission. But I think what he's most remembered for is his role as the Vajpayee government's premier diplomat in that period between 1998 and the early 2000s, the post 9/11 period, which was an extremely challenging period for India. And in terms of the nuclear test and explaining the nuclear test and normalizing relations with the US and the West after that, the terror incidents one after the other from Pakistan-based terrorists, including the attack on Parliament, and 9/11 and its aftermath, Afghanistan. It was a very, very challenging period, and he was very much leading from the front. I mean, he led the ministry from the front. He led Indian diplomacy from the front, of course, as part of a team led by Prime Minister Vajpayee, and including NSA Bradesh Mishra. That would be his lasting legacy.
Yeah, you know, as a founder member of the BJP, his association with leaders like Atal Bihari Vajpayee, L.K. Advani, and so many others, Murali Manohar Joshi, Sushma Swaraj, they were, you know, founders and core members of an older generation within the BJP. And he was absolutely an intrinsic part of that group that came to define a certain aspect of Indian politics, which has now become dominant.
Yes, as you said, I you know, given my current position, I don't really want to talk about politics, Vishnu, you will understand that. I'd like to limit myself to his role as India's external affairs minister and India's engagement with the world. He played a very, very important role in giving the BJP, which was then in opposition, a foreign policy orientation and thinking about foreign policy, thinking through India's external engagement with the world and how what the Vajpayee government could bring, which would be different from previous governments. So in a sense, he was responsible for the early modernization, or part of the team responsible for the early modernization of Indian diplomacy in the late 90s post-Pokhran period, something which has been continued by the current government, by Mr. Modi's government. You know, the engagement with the US, the very ambitious engagement with the US, not a defensive one, but an ambitious one, especially after ending the nuclear ambiguity, the engagement with the Arab world and the UAE, Mr. Modi has taken it forward, but one should remember that the early steps were taken by Mr. Jaswant Singh and Mr. Vajpayee's government. The 2001 breakthrough visit to Myanmar, which has again led to a great projects and interaction and connectivity under the current government. There is a vast degree of continuity between that era of the BJP and that government and this one, which one should also recognize.
Yeah. India's nuclear doctrine, he had a fairly major role in defining where we stand as a nuclear power.
I can't hear you very well. I think you asked a question about the nuclear, India's nuclear test.
Yes, nuclear doctrine. Further to the test.
So, I think in the period after the nuclear test, to present India as a responsible nuclear power, which is something which stood us in good stead over the next 20 years under successive governments, and has led to gains for India, to present India as a responsible nuclear power, as a power that could be part of nuclear rule making, which we deserve to be, because we are striving to become full members of the NSG. This government's endeavor as well. Also staving off pressure to sign CTBT. He did not succumb to that pressure, and Jaswant Singh's negotiations with Stroke Talbot played a role there. While adhering to a voluntary moratorium on testing, which we have again stuck by, I think this is a testimony to his remarkable negotiation skills and his ability to persuade friends on behalf of India persuade the United States, especially on behalf of India, in the post-Pokhran period, which was a very, very difficult period, as you will remember. And he had very few cards to play, but he played them very well.
Yeah, his one of the biggest challenges to Jaswant Singh would have been Kandahar. And, you know, I mean, a government which was tough talking against terrorism, having to sort of negotiate with terrorists, and his personal decision to go to Kandahar. Your thoughts on that?
You know the circumstances that happened in the last week, the pressures on the last week of December 1999. And in fact, you were on television that week, I remember watching.
Yeah.
all I would say was, I once asked Jaswant Singh why he went to Kandahar. And he said, if there were last minute decisions to be taken, last minute calls to be taken, which were beyond a civil servant's mandate or duty, a politician needed to be there, a minister needed to be there to take them, and I was going to go there. So he did not duck a challenge. It was his responsibility. He went there. He wasn't happy doing it. It was a very tough and challenging moment, and not a happy moment at all. But he went there, he the buck stopped with him. He said, I will go there and do this. This is my duty to India. And, you know, years later, he wrote about going back to Afghanistan just after 9/11, just after it had been liberated, and comparing that visit to his last visit to Afghanistan, which was, of course, on December 31st, 1999. And there was a sense of vindication, because do remember the investments we made in Afghanistan, in the development of Afghanistan, in building a post-9/11 Afghanistan. That was also Jaswant Singh's legacy. And that, again, has stood us in good stead for the next 20 years.
It has indeed. Thank you so much, Mr. Malik. Thanks very much indeed for sharing all of those thoughts.